design of whizbiz.com. In a previous movie, we saw that we can project these so-called hypocycloids with a small semiconductor laser and two revolving mirrors. But what if we don't spin the mirrors, but let each mirror vibrate only about one axis, like this? So I took my 6-speed gearbox made from Fisher Technique again and replaced the two revolving mirrors on the output side with mirrors that each deflect only one axis. One for the deflection of the laser along the x-axis and another one to deflect along the y-axis. If we do so, we're able to project Lissajous figures! But what are Lissajous figures actually? Well, take a look at these four sine waves at the top here. They define the x-coordinate of a point, with frequencies 1, 2, 3 and 4 times. And over here the same frequency ratios, but they define the y-coordinates of the figures that show up in the matrix over here. Depending on those ratios, you'll get different figures. For example, if the vibration in the x direction is 3 times as large as in the y direction, the deflected point will describe a path like this figure. And if you swap x and y, it will be the same figure, but with the axes swapped. Same figure, but 90 degrees rotated. If the frequency ratio is 1 to 1, we'll see a circle. The difference in phase between these waves determines which side of the circle we actually see. In this case, this appears to be a straight front view, so we see a clean circle. But with shifted phase, the circle appears to be a single diagonal line on this oscilloscope. These two waves of 2 kHz determine the x and y coordinates of each point of the figures through the formulas, and because both frequencies are equal here, we're looking at the side of a circle. This projects a stable figure because the frequency ratios are exact, and if we double the y frequency, we'll get this figure. And with a frequency ratio of 1 to 3, we'll get a Lissajous figure like this. Let's make it 1 to 4 by cranking up the frequency to 8, so the ratio is 1 to 4. It looks like this. But it even gets better, because by slightly varying one of the frequencies, the ratio is no longer precise and the figure will start to move. Interactive television! Who needs Netflix when you can view this? In the description of this movie, you'll find a link to the project page, and over there, you'll find a link to the simulator online. Here you can play around with the Lissajous figures without an oscilloscope, and this is our diagonal line, which is in fact a disguised circle if we change the phase between the two frequencies. As you can see, you can even animate the whole thing. And with double the frequency on one of the channels, you get a Lissajous figure like this. Interesting enough, you can count the peaks of the figure in each direction to find out the ratio. For instance, 1, 2, 3 gives you 3 peaks in the x direction and 1 only in the y direction. 2 to 3 gives you, well, depends a little bit on the view. Let's give it a little bit of phase shifting. 1, 2, 3. And on the other side, in the y direction, only 2, so this is a ratio of 2 to 3. And the more we crank up the frequency ratio, the more we get these nice bracelet kind of figures on our screen. Okay, so let's see if we can use the double 6-speed gearbox from the last video. Then of course we have to change the revolving mirrors, the wobbly mirrors, for these oscillating mirrors. One to deflect the x-axis and one to deflect the y-axis of the laser beam. So we have our two mirrors now, each wiggling in its own direction. But will this project clear Lissajous figures? Well, I see a bit more than I can capture on video, but the resulting projection is, as you can see, just more or less a swift moving dot of light with this construction. As we already concluded in the last video, the speed of the mirrors turned out to be a little low to project well recognizable figures. Might be a good idea to crank up the speed of each mirror by powering it with its own motor, just as we did with the hypocycloids. But first, let's have an intermezzo about these small semiconductor lasers. This purple one, the one you saw working perfectly fine on the footage a moment ago, just seemed to be dying on me. I noticed that the current surged up over 700 milliamps, and now the light output is degraded, just leaving this dim spot. And I just learned it suffered from so-called catastrophic optical damage. If you don't limit the current through these things, they may get too hot and burn themselves to death. So for the rest of the experiments, I have to replace it with this small 5 milliwatt red laser. And you'll bet I'll be sure to limit that current. By the way, that purple laser was powered up with my own power module that has a configurable fuse, but well, I just had no clue. I better had limited that to a few hundred milliamps. Now it was set to 1 amp, and that unfortunately resulted in a damaged laser. But we'll just go on with our experiments. When we just power each mirror with its own motor and leave out the gearbox, we can gain a lot of space. Since I didn't want to use levers at these high speeds, I tried a different way of creating a wobbly movement and printed an oval-shaped roller like this. The X mirror is supported by a little table. The Y deflection vibrates freely hanging from two springs, so it might be more sensitive to the disturbing influences of vibration and backslash than this X deflector. And as you can see, it seems to wobble very fine on its own small table over there. Now let's power up the vertical deflector. I'm not quite sure yet if it doesn't vibrate too much in other directions. The swing is also a bit smaller here because it takes the movement a little bit further away from the roller. For now, let me replace the projection screen so we can see if the speed is high enough to beam clearly recognizable Lissajous figures with it. Okay, so we're all set for the final experiment. But first, let's take a more closer look at both these deflectors here. Because of the horizontal support, that looks quite good for the horizontal deflector. So let's see what the vertical deflector does. Yeah, what we expected. Unfortunately, that line is a bit shorter and it's also a bit shaky due to disturbances. But let's power them both up and we'll get projections like these. Again, I'm afraid it's quite difficult to capture this all on video. You probably only see a fast moving dot. Wow, this is most definitely a lot of fun to play with, and probably as far as we can get in projecting these Lissajous figures with a semiconductor laser in a purely mechanical way. We might conclude the stable projections require fairly high speeds, and it's difficult to minimize the disturbing influences on the mechanical deflectors. The influence of vibrations and backslash quickly translates in a somewhat shivering projection line here. Moreover, the relatively low oscillation speed limits the recognizability of the figures. And, well, of course, a mechanical solution like this will never be used in a professional laser projection. They use laser galvanometers there, which makes it possible to modulate the mirrors much faster and more accurately. Well, perhaps next step is to go completely electronical and try to find out if we can construct our own laser galvos from small DC motors. But in the meantime, if you like these videos, just subscribe to my channel. For now, I think I'll just play a little bit more with this setup, and I hope I might have inspired you to do your own experiments. So keep playing and creating, and I hope to see you with my next video. Until then, I conclude with a well-meant happy hacking!